What's up guys, Sal here. So the Galaxy S21 Ultra has the best battery life on any smartphone out there. Much of this credit goes to the new 5nm chipsets, which are not only powerful, but at the same time are power efficient too. There's one more reason why the Galaxy S21 Ultra outperforms the competition in battery life, even though the competition is also using the 5nm chipsets. Well, that's because the S21 Ultra also uses the world's first power efficient OLED panels that consume 16% less power thanks to a newly developed organic material that can create brighter light while consuming less power, which improves the battery lifetime. No other smartphone has this display, not even the Galaxy S21 and S21 Plus. As you can see, I have upgraded to the Galaxy S21 Ultra and have been using it for a few days now. And I can confirm the battery life on this phone is really good, which is refreshing to see on a Samsung phone after a long time. The phone was 100% charged when I woke up yesterday, and it's almost evening the next day and the phone still has some juice left, which wasn't possible on the Galaxy S20 Ultra or Note 20 Ultra. So yes, not only you have the best display on this phone that can go crazy bright, but also it doesn't drain the battery as the previous displays. Anyway, after using the S21 Ultra, I can finally say this is how a true Ultra phone is actually made. Unlike last year's Ultra phones, they haven't compromised anything with this phone. You can actually see the difference when you turn on 120Hz at WQHD+. Everything just looks better. It's the biggest problem I had with last year's Ultra phones, but glad Samsung isn't making us choose between high res and high refresh rate this time. Also, you can notice the bigger ultrasonic fingerprint scanner not only is faster than last time, I mean just a tap would unlock it, but you are very unlikely to have a failed unlock attempt since the scanning area is 77% bigger than last year's phones. The phone came with a very thin protector, almost invisible in fact, applied in the factory. It's plastic and will be good only against scratches, but it's still better than nothing. Then there's the glass back, which is now matte, and I love the frosted feeling while touching it. Unlike the Note 20 Ultra, it's not slippery at all, but easily catches fingerprints. Compared to the S20 Ultra, it's a tad shorter due to a smaller screen. But even though it's no thicker or heavier than S20 Ultra, the S21 Ultra feels bulkier because of its shorter curves. You can use any stylus with this phone, as you can see it works with the Note 20 Ultra's S Pen 2, but the Bluetooth functions won't work for now. The advanced S Pen features will come with a software update once the Bluetooth S Pen Pro launches later this year. By the way, the latency is similar to the Note 20 Ultra. Since the camera sensor size is big on this phone, it can take amazing macro shots. You don't even need to toggle a button on or off, just take the phone near the subject and it will automatically switch to the macro shots. The speakers on this phone are louder than the S20 Ultra. The vocals are well presented, the high notes play nice, and the bass is decent. It's comparable with the iPhone 12 Pro Max. As for the performance, this is a beast of a machine, the most powerful hardware so far, so without a doubt, it is and will continue to be a powerhouse for the next couple of years. Things are done effortlessly on the Ultra, no matter the app or game, resolution, and frame rate. By the way, I've been testing a couple of games on this and I couldn't reach the point where I would notice throttling, not even running a game for a long time. And that's more than enough by my books to be happy with the performance and the power management. By the way, I have the Exynos variant with 12GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Anyway, I'll keep pushing this phone to its limits and we'll compare the performance with the other two Ultra phones from Samsung in my next video. Let me know if you want to see that by liking the video. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.